When I was in 11th grade, I received my first ever summer homework assignment. To this day, I still find it to be one of the gravest injustices I have ever had to endure. Summer is not a time for homework. I'm over it now. But it was pretty simple, right? All I had to do was read a book, write a 2-page paper. Nothing much to it. I opened up the book, and I was beside myself. I didn't get it. I didn't understand it. It was difficult. It was going to take way too much time. And I realized I might be in over my head. I went to my dad and said, "Please, Dad, let me drop the course. I'm not smart enough for this. Let me go to the easier English class. It'll be fine." He said no. He said, "You'll learn something." I said, "No, I won't." He said, "Yes, you're not dropping the class." Turns out, I did learn something. I got a B in the class and learned basically everything I know about writing. So, don't you just hate it when dads are right? The reason I tell this story is because a few years ago I was in seminary and I was looking back and realizing how good I had it. You see, as a seminarian, as someone training to be a priest, we sort of need to know a little bit about everything, about Bible, liturgy, we need moral theology, history, all the things that people might need to know. And because of this, our workload can be a little heavy. And one semester, I was reading 100 pages and writing 4 2-page papers every single week. And I just thought, what was I doing complaining 10 years ago? What, that was so easy. How much I would love to be able to do just that. But then there was another thought. It was an interesting thought. And I thought, how did I change? What happened? How did I get from there to here? What was so difficult long ago is now, in fact, kind of easy. Look how much more I'm doing. But I guess that's kind of the essence. That's kind of what growth is. Does anyone ever really feel themselves growing? And yet, here we are, taller than we were when we were children. Does anyone ever feel their hair getting longer? Probably not. And yet, we gotta get a haircut every once in a while. What about our spiritual lives? Do we ever feel ourselves getting holier, growing closer to God? Maybe not. And yet, that's what we're called to do. That's what we, most of us, are in fact doing. St. Paul tells us this week that the Spirit is working in us, and the Spirit will continue to work into us until we are brought to completion on the day of Jesus Christ. We are all called to be saints, and God is working in us to make that possible. Now, this might be a difficult pill to swallow. Me, a saint? I don't know, brother. You just don't know me. Yes, each and every one of us is called to be a saint. But I understand the hesitancy, because I feel it too. When I look at someone like St. Francis of Assisi, what an amazing man he was, so holy, founded 3 orders, changed the church and world. I can't be like that. There's no way. When I look at someone like Mother Teresa, how she gave her life for the poor, lived in one of the poorest places in the entire world, what extraordinary things she did, I think, I couldn't do that. There's no way. So often when I look at the great saints, I revert back to who I was in 11th grade, thinking, I am way over my head. There is no way I can do this. Please, just let me drop the course. I don't need to be a saint. But then I remember. Then I remember that St. Francis wasn't always St. Francis. When he was a teenager, when he was, say, 11th grade, he was kind of a party boy. He kind of wanted to be a knight, and he was all about himself, very selfish. He just wanted the glory. He just wanted to be special. He wasn't a saint. In fact, he did some pretty terrible things. It took him an entire lifetime, one step at a time, year after year, to grow to who he became. He wasn't born that way. Mother Teresa was the same way. We can look at her at the end of life as she was the founder of an order. But at one point, she was just a little Albanian girl, probably struggling with her own 11th grade homework. Looking at the saints and feeling overwhelmed, being inspired by them, but far from where they were. Little by little, over her entire life, she built up an entire resume, but it didn't happen on the first day. I think it can be difficult sometimes to look at the end when we're right here at the beginning. We don't come out of the baptismal font always holy. We're not done at confirmation. In fact, these sacraments, these stages in our lives, are just the beginning. We are called to take those things and to go much further. God is calling us to be holy, to be saints, and He will continue to bring that work in us to completion until the day that Jesus comes. But we need to take those steps. Now, we may take one step forward and two steps back. Sometimes we sin. Sometimes we fall. Sometimes we don't become immediately what we hope for. But just like me 10 years ago, just like so many of us, growth does happen. We may not feel it. We may not see it. And in fact, sometimes we may even take a step back. But we always need to trust. Trust that it's not us that's growing, that not us that's controlling, it's not us who's special, but that the Holy Spirit is in us, working in us, calling us, pulling us, and making us holy. It's not about us being special. It's not about us feeling the growth, but trusting that it is happening because our Lord is in us. And so I wonder with you, I wonder if you can take one step forward today. You don't have to go the entire journey. It's not Christmas yet. It's not the moment of glory. But maybe just take a step this second week of Advent, just one. And then after you've done that, take one more step. And then one more step. And they may be very tiny, but over the course of an entire season, over the course of an entire lifetime, what we find is that we've traveled very, very far without even knowing it. We might be the next St. Francis, the next Mother Teresa, but it starts with one step and trusting that God will be leading the way.